Hello and welcome to another edition of Woman's Page. It's a program presented, as usual, by Frankie Byrne. And it's presented, as always, by the people who make fig rolls figure. Every figgin' day. And Paul Clark as well. My first letter today comes from a listener who signs herself Delirious. Crosshaven. Although her real name is Maureen Murphy, 23 Seafield Terrace, Crosshaven, County Cork. Hi, Maureen. And now, the problems I'm discussing today may not be yours, but they could be someday. If you're very lucky. She writes, Dear Frankie, I'm a young girl of 27 and a half. Stone. And I'm going out now, Frankie, with a young man who's only 6 and a half stone. He loves me, Frankie. He adores the ground I walk upon. And he knows that he'll always be sure of a roof over his head if he marries me. Because my daddy is a builder. Now, Frankie, I don't love him. I have a crush on him, if you know what I mean. Now, Frankie, I live alone with my twin sister, who's 3 years older than me by nearly 2.5 weeks. And I have a passion for the postman. It's called Postman's Passion, Frankie. Now, he's a fine man, Frankie. He is a young man. He couldn't be any more than 33. Well, he's between 33 and 52. And he's a tall, handsome man, 6 foot, 13 and a half, approximately, covered from head to toe with hair. Honestly, you'd think his mother was after knitting him. And what I like mostly about him, Frankie, is the way he uses the post office bicycle. He has so much respect for Albert. That's what he calls the bicycle, Albert. He holds it like that. Not like that, Frankie, like that. And he runs along beside it like this. And when he builds up speed, he puts his left foot on the pedal and propels himself with the right foot like this. And when he builds up momentum, he throws his right leg across the saddle and he planks himself down. And then he disappears over the horizon, Frankie. Many's the time, I wish it was me he was delivering the letters to in the morning. A dirty laugh. But anyway. I never get letters, Frankie. And I decided to send myself a parcel. So he arrived one day when I was in the kitchen. Now, Frankie, I was out cooking at the time. Now, I'm not a good cook. Even my dustbins have ulcers, Frankie. But I was in the kitchen. He knocked on the door with the bicycle. And I didn't answer. I was playing hard to get. I've always played hard to get, Frankie. That's why I've never been got. But he started to lose his temper outside, Frankie. And eventually, I could hear him shouting through the letterbox. Through the letterbox! Through the letterbox! Through the letterbox! So I opened the door, Frankie, in my nightdress. That's a funny place to have a door, I know. But I had to let him in. Yeah, to the house. Frankie. It was a two-story bungalow. Now, he stayed for a while and we looked at each other. He looked at me and I looked at him and he looked back at me and I looked back at him. We had a great look, Frankie. He went off, out the door, realizing he was half an hour late with his deliveries, grabbed his bicycle, started to run profusely up the street, placed his left foot on the pedal, propelled himself with the right foot like that, and he didn't realize, Frankie, that some young gurrier had stolen the saddle off the bicycle. As he was about to throw his leg, I tried to shout, "Don't throw it, don't throw it." But it was too late, Frankie. Over it went and down he came like a ton of bricks. Well, he turned a whiter shade of pale. After the ambulance went, I followed on to the hospital. And he was 3 hours in the operating theater. Oh, yes, Frankie, that's how long it took them to remove the bicycle. Now, yes. And the surgeon told me, only for the handlebars, they never... Anyway, Frankie. Now,